Hey guys, Cal here with a new video on Marvel Spider-Man 2. We're almost 3 weeks away from the game's release date, so I thought it was a great time to fill in the gap between Spider-Man Miles Morales and the upcoming sequel. To those of you who may be asking, Cal, what are you on about? The way it works is, we play the last few games of the sequel, including any DLCs, and boom, we're up to date. And you would normally be right, but for Marvel Spider-Man 2, did you know there was a prequel comic that takes place between Miles Morales and Spider-Man 2? To those of you who are familiar with this comic, I thought it was a great time to get a refresher of the events of the comic to be prepared for anything that you may encounter while playing Spider-Man 2. And for those of you who aren't familiar, well, grab your seats as I'm about to tell you. Also, if you're one of those people who are excited to learn about new details of Spider-Man 2, then definitely make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel to be updated on any important Spider-Man 2 news or content. The comic begins with a battle between the Spider-Man of Peter and Miles and Tarantula, a villain who uses a four-armed mechanical exoskeleton packed with blades and weapons. As Peter mentions during the battle, this is not the first time he's fought this arachnid villain. Tarantula and Peter fought when Marvel's Spider-Man debuted in Spider-Geddon. The Hood and his followers are the main villains in this comic book prequel. Although the Hood presents himself as a magic-wielding master of dark forces, he's really just a normal man named Parker Robbins, who is searching for a mystical tablet that could potentially heal his dying mother. While the Hood's powers in this story are based on stolen technology, his counterpart in the Marvel Universe really wields mystical powers. In the comics, the Hood stole a demonic cloak and boots that allowed him to briefly turn invisible and walk on air. Although he initially used his mystical powers to steal money to support his alien mother, the Hood went on to build one of the most formidable criminal empires in the Marvel Universe and battled the new Avengers with villains like Loki, Norman Osborn, and Dormammu. In Spider-Man Miles Morales, the Tinkerer, who was really Miles' friend Finn Mason, and her allies in the underground tried to bring down the Roxxon Corporation with weapons built around programmable nanotechnology. Although Finn is dead and the underground is no more, the Hood and his crew are using modified versions of the Tinkerer's technology to commit their crime spree in this comic. After examining the invisibility cloaks the Hood's gang wore, Miles realizes that the Hood probably found a leftover cache of programmable matter tech and modified it to suit his needs. One of the captured henchmen says that the Hood can walk on air. Miles mentions that the Hood is probably using a modified version of the highly advanced boots that Finn and her team used to jump and climb throughout the city. To save his ailing mother, the Hood tries to use the Lifeline Tablet, an ancient artifact that can allegedly heal the sick and raise the dead. While the Hood's efforts to use the tablet in this story were unsuccessful, the Lifeline Tablet is a powerful mystical artifact in the Marvel Universe. Also known as the Tablet of Life and Time, the Lifeline Tablet has been part of the Web-Slinger's world since its debut in The Amazing Spider-Man issue 68. When the Spider-Men and Mary Jane are catching up after their fight with Tarantula, Miles shows Peter his modifications to the Spider Lure. Peter originally designed these devices to emit a pinging sound that could distract nearby enemies, and MJ used these lures to sneak past enemy henchmen during her stealth missions in Marvel's Spider-Man. While Peter's lures could only distract, Miles' upgrades gives the lures offensive capabilities as well. Now the lures can produce an ear-splitting frequency that dazes their targets and interferes with some technology. In this story, Miles and MJ successfully used a modified spider lure to scramble the cloaking technology that the Hood was using to make himself invisible and leave his ears ringing. While investigating the Hood's efforts to buy the Lifeline Tablet, Miles kept finding references to someone known as the Foreigner. Although he does not appear in this comic, the Foreigner is an assassin who has had numerous encounters with Spider-Man in the comic book universe. By making direct eye contact with someone, he can hypnotize them and send them into a trance for 10 seconds, which makes his targets think that he has super speed. While talking with Miles in the comic, Peter recalls an unseen encounter in one of his oldest villains, the Sandman. Although that encounter has not been shown in detail, Marvel's Spider-Man featured two references to the classic Spider-Man villain. While welcoming Miles to his first volunteer shift at the feast, Aunt May recalls how she stopped Sandman from robbing the shelter by pointing out that there was nothing worth stealing there. Elsewhere in the game, Peter finds an old backpack containing a vial filled with several grains of Sandman sand and jokes about whether opening it will release Sandman back into the world. As a senior at Brooklyn Visions Academy, Miles is thinking about his future and what he wants to study in college. Wanting to combine his passion for making music with his love of the sciences, Miles wants to attend Empire State University for its music technology program, where he can pursue both interests simultaneously. In addition to being Peter's alma mater, ESU was heavily featured in Marvel's Spider-Man. For example, Peter crashed a Halloween party on campus while trying to protect a professor from Mr. Negative. On several subsequent missions, Peter searched for few missing ESU students and freed other students who had fallen under Mr. Negative's influence. In this comic, Miles asks Peter to write him an alumni recommendation letter as he begins the college application process. After serving as the publisher of the Daily Bugle newspaper for years, J. Jonah Jameson moved on to host a podcast called Just the Facts for his fact channel in Marvel's Spider-Man. After using his podcast to voice his frequent criticism of Spider-Man and occasional support of Mayor Norman Osborn, Jameson makes a deal to return to the Daily Bugle in this comic. On his podcast, Jameson gets into an argument with Mary Jane over their drastically different approaches to journalism. Before their interview can finish, the Spider-Man's battle with Tarantula crashes into their studio, much like the Spider-Man's battle with the Rhino did in Marvel's Spider-Man Miles Morales. After making the Bugle's current owners an offer to buy the newspaper back, Jameson wants to show Mary Jane and her generation of reporters his sensational approach to practicing journalism. Anyway, what do you guys think of this prequel comic? Do let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.